Today on the Meredith Vieira Show, Steve Harvey on Dressing Up. Plus, Kenny may be homeless, but his only dream is to help his mom.
What is it that makes your mom so amazing?
She helped me with everything. She's Wonder Woman.
Now, Meredith has a few surprises for this amazing young man. Right now on the Meredith Vieira Show.
Story about how a simple photograph can help transform a child's hopes and dreams. 8 years ago, I met a woman who has forever changed the way I look at one of these. With her program, Pictures of Hope, she's proving how putting a camera in a child's hands can bring their hopes and dreams sharply into focus.
I was unaware that the average age of someone homeless is 7 years old. It's very unfair for these little darling children to have to go through this.
Linda Solomon, a celebrity photographer who has captured images of the likes of Halle Berry and Bradley Cooper, was so disturbed by the plight of homeless children that 8 years ago she founded a program called Pictures of Hope.
Isaiah!
Which surprises children in homeless shelters by giving them cameras so they can photograph their dreams.
I hope to be a soldier. My hope to be a teacher.
My hope is to ride on a rocket.
The children begin by writing a list of their hopes and dreams, and they go off and they capture those dreams.
Rip it open, Alan.
All photojournalists today, right? You want to hold the camera very steady.
With a few photography tips to get them started, the kids are off, snapping away.
Hey, geez. Let me take a picture of you.
The photos of their dreams are made into holiday greeting cards, which are sold to raise money for the shelters they live in. But what's especially touching is that even though they don't have homes of their own, often their dreams have nothing to do with their own needs.
I hope for no hunger, no wars, and I wish to stop sickness.
I want each child to feel special, to know that someone cares about your hopes and your dreams.
Yes!
And now I can get on the road to achievement because my dream is right in front of me. It's in my camera.
Please welcome the founder of Pictures of Hope, Linda Solomon. Nice to see you, Linda.
Nice seeing you, Mary.
Thank you. You have talked about how it's easier for kids to imagine their dreams coming true if they can see them actually
yes.
in a photo. When did you really come to understand and appreciate the power of a picture?
Well, I think with the children, sometimes verbally, it's so difficult to share something that's so deep within. But through an art form, and through photography, they can open up and share these very poignant hopes and dreams.
What are some of the photos that have, I mean, you've seen thousands of them at this point.
I have.
That moved you the most?
Well, there was a photo taken by a child in Memphis, Marlon, age 10.
My hope is to show people I am not a nobody.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh.
And you can imagine when I watched as he had written that on his list of hopes and dreams, and I didn't want him to see me cry, but to look at that dream of his. So Pictures of Hope build self-esteem. It shows the children their dreams are respected. It shows the children their dreams matter. 100% of the proceeds go right back to the shelters from these beautiful Pictures of Hope cards.
I want the audience to take a look at this particular photo, if we can put it up, taken by a young girl named Brittany Pemberton when she was 9 years old. She's now 16 and she is here today. Hi, Brittany. Nice to see you.
Hello.
Hi. Brittany, when you snapped that picture, like I said, you were 9 years old. You were living in a shelter with your mom and your brother. Your dad was actually away at rehab.
Mm-hmm.
Why that picture? Why did you take that picture?
I took that picture because nobody else in my family had graduated from college, and I really wanted to change the course of the way that my family had been going. So instead of following in the footsteps of everybody else, I really wanted to pioneer a new way. And Linda Solomon helped me do that.
Well, I think it's, um, I, th- think it's pretty incredible what happened to you after you took that picture. Can you share that with the audience?
After I took that picture, we went on a tour of San Diego State University, and they said that maybe we could meet the president and just pop in really fast. And we ended up going in, and there was news cameras everywhere, and he sat down and he handed me a fancy folder, and he said that there was a 4-year scholarship, and that's what it meant. Oh. And so...
And Brittany is actually, you're entering your senior year in high school, and so this will be for the next year. You're going to college, which is so exciting, and your mom, Tanya, sitting next to you. Tanya, you've said of that one picture that it didn't just change Brittany's life, it changed the lives of everybody in your family. How so?
You know, really, Pictures of Hope met us at a time where hope for us was hard to come by. And it gave us, our family, the opportunity to really hope again and to see a brighter future.
And I know it was the Salvation Army that took you in way back when, and now you're wearing the uniform. You are working for them now?
I'm not only working for them, I'm becoming a pastor in the Salvation Army, so.
So is your husband. Thank you guys for sharing your story. Thank you so much.
Thank
we have
you.
A lot more. Up next, Thank one you. Boy's wish for his mother actually comes true. We'll be right back. Today we are talking about Pictures of Hope, a program that inspires children to photograph their dreams. Well, recently we went with founder Linda Solomon to Hillside House, a shelter for homeless families in Queens, New York. And it's where we met a remarkable 11-year-old boy named Kenny.
When Kenny St. Frank was told to photograph his dream, this was the picture he snapped.
My dream is to help my mom to whatever hard thing that she has to go through.
Of all the things an 11-year-old boy could dream for, Kenny's wish is simply to help his mom.
We're this close. If you glue it together, that's how close we are.
Kenny and his mom, Nancy, have an especially tight bond because they've spent the last 7 years moving in and out of homeless shelters.
In the last few years, life has been challenging.
Some of the shelters have been dangerous, others unsanitary.
I used to live in another shelter, which wasn't good at all. It was one of the most horrible experiences for us, both of us.
Yes.
We had mold in the apartment, and also bacteria was coming through the water in the wall, so it wasn't safe.
Nancy's minimum wage job as a home health aide isn't nearly enough to afford even a small New York apartment.
The challenge is being able to thrive with the minimum wage salary, which is not working for me at all.
And even if the shelters put a temporary roof over their heads, it's an unstable existence.
We can't live here for a long time, so I'm a little bit worried about that.
Kenny worries that they will never have a real home. But all this 11-year-old boy really wants is to see his mom happy.
She's a wonderful mom, and I love her very much. And when I get enough money, I'll give it to her to help her.
Please welcome Nancy and Kenny St. Frank. Kenny, I told you backstage that I would be so proud to have a son like you. You really are a lovely, lovely young man. What is it? Yeah, my sister deserves your applause. What is it that makes your mom so amazing?
Well, it's very simple. What makes my mom so amazing is that she really, really is an amazing mom. She helps me with everything. Like, if I need help with something or if I'm going down with something, she will come and ask me, what's up, how are you feeling? Like, she's Wonder Woman. Wonder Woman to me.
Well, then let me ask you, Wonder Woman. I mean, of all the pictures he could have taken, the fact that he took a picture of the word mom, what did that mean to you?
Well, to me, it's very unique. It's out of the ordinary. It's special. And it also mostly represents the quality time that we spend together.
So you are trying as best you can to make his life as full and happy as possible. What are your hopes for Kenny?
Well, my hopes for Kenny is for him to excel in school, to push himself, to study hard, to work hard, because
education is the key for his life right now.
Are you studying hard?
You know it.
Kenny, you said that all you want is for your mom to be happy. What do you think would truly make your mom happy?
What really would make my mom happy is that if she didn't worry a lot, she could just do and do it in an orderly fashion. Like, if she has a bill, if she has to do a bill, she won't have to worry. She would just do the bill and that's it. Like, she doesn't have to worry. She has to be exhausted, frustrated. You know, those negative feelings that way. No negative feelings.
No negative feelings. None. Well, I know you have one less thing to worry about. Let me share this news with our audience. Great news. Nancy and Kenny, you've been waiting 2 years for affordable housing. Last week, they got the keys to a new two-bedroom apartment through the New York City Housing Authority. And we thought, that's fabulous. That is so fabulous. But, you know, a house isn't a home unless there's some furniture. Right?
Yes.
So we contacted Jennifer Convertibles, and I want to take you look at the monitor there because they're loading a truck. You're getting some furniture. A dining room set,
oh my God.
And you're getting two bedroom sets because you've been sharing the same bed.
Oh my God!
Nice, you like?
It's very cool.
I'm so glad.
Oh, but, you know, thank you.
Oh, you're so welcome. But we have one more little surprise for you, Nance. We want to invest in your future, not just the present, but the future. I know your dream is to go back to school to get training in the court system as an interpreter. So Hofstra University is giving you a scholarship for a year of continued education courses. And you're gonna need a laptop computer, so we're giving you the laptop computer.
Are you serious? Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God,
and
God,
we're setting you up with a career counselor that can advise you as you move forward so you make all the right steps.
I'm speechless.
And you know why? Because you so deserve it. And
thank
that picture
you.
Moved all of us. It really
yeah.
did.
Yes,
and your story
you.
Moved all of us as well. And Linda, thank you for everything
thank you,
you do.
Thank you so
on
much.
A regular
congratulations.
Basis.
Thank you.
And if you want to learn more about Pictures of Hope, you can go to our website at MeredithVieiraShow.com. We'll be right back.